Hey, what's going on, guys? Prestige here, and today I have some Black Ops 2? What? This is some old gameplay, and you'll notice that as soon as you see my emblem in this game. I'm actually using a diamond vector. This was supposed to be part of the Road to Diamond, but I figured I would use this gameplay to talk a little bit about the new camouflages that were announced for March 4th, which is very surprising to me. Surprising that there's going to be even more support and even more DLC coming for a previous game like Black Ops 2. You know, Ghosts right now is the current title, but Treyarch is still going to support DLC with the form of microtransactions, which I think, personally, is awesome. I love the microtransactions. I like being able to customize my weapons. I like being able to give the game a fresh look for me. And I've talked about this countless times before, especially when you are just looking at your character in a first-person view. You're always looking at the weapon, so why not switch it up? Why not change it? That's why I really enjoyed getting, diamond camouflage, gold camouflage, all the different types of camouflage in Call of Duty Black Ops 2. And it's the same reason I like doing it in Call of Duty Ghosts. It's just a little bit more difficult, in my opinion. I think it's a little bit harder to navigate the maps in Call of Duty Ghosts. I don't know if anyone else noticed that, but let's go ahead and put these camouflages up on the screen. There's going to be four of them, and the first one's going to be weaponized 115, Dead Man's Hand, Beast, and Octane. That's going to be the four packs coming. I'm sure that they're going to cost $1.99, just like they were before, but with these packs, or actually I don't even know if they were $1.99 before. They might be a little bit more. I'm not sure yet. I'll look it up and I'll put it in the description below as soon as I figure it out. But if you remember in Black Ops 2, you were able to get the camouflage, you also got a reticle, you also got a player card, and the last couple player cards we got with the last couple DLCs we got, they were actually like animated. They would move, and I thought that was so cool. And what I really wanted was the Paladin camouflage. I know that no one else voted for it. We got, I think it was Cyborg in that little vote war we had, but I really, really wanted Paladin. PC got Paladin. But if they're still supporting, like I said before, the microtransactions after the fact that the game's already been out, then there's really no stopping them from putting it in there now after the fact the game has already been out for a while. Another reason I'm thinking that they're doing this is because now that the games are set in 3-year cycles, because we have Sledgehammer Games producing, a Call of Duty game, I think that it gives them more time to be able to kind of work with the previous titles that they have, provide more support with the previous titles, as opposed to kind of cutting off all support altogether to move to the next one to put all their, you know, time and effort into the next one. They're going to have more balance in between their current game that they have and the one that's going to be coming out within the next couple of years. So I think that's, you know, just my personal opinion. There's still some more money to be made on each of these games. I mean, honestly speaking, I think that, you know, as the Call of Duty community, if they were to release, let's just say, another map pack, you know, there's no confirming this or anything, I'm just throwing this out there. If they were to release, let's say, a throwback map pack or something, I've talked about this previously too, you know, as a Call of Duty community, I'm sure that we would all love to play some old school maps. I mean, just imagine if they did like a Call of Duty 4 Appreciation Day or something on Modern Warfare 2 or Modern Warfare 3, where you can download each and every single map, for half off from previous games like Call of Duty 4. You can download, Modern Warfare 3 maps on Call of Duty Ghosts, you know, things like that. I think people would love that. And altogether, I know that this doesn't mean much coming from me, but I think that as a Call of Duty community, we would love to see a remake of these old school games. I think, you know, with how esports is now and how big that community is, I think esports and Call of Duty 4 would just be like bread and, you know, PB&J, bread and butter, salt and pepper. It would go together so well. It would just merge into something so beautiful. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this quick video. If you did, drop a like. If not, that's cool. Keep in mind, I'm on the road to 250,000 subscribers. If you'd like to hit that subscribe button, please feel free to do so. And until next time, I am out. Peace.